Hi. I'm not a big fan of celebrities, honestly. You know, there are, of course, exceptions. Yeah, like Clint Eastwood, for instance. But I think most of them, many of them at least, are so full of themselves. They are so important, aren't they? Yeah. And I remembered something today that we have a lesbian couple, celebrities here in Sweden, two women, Eva Dahlgren and Eva Attling. Eva Dahlgren is a singer-songwriter and Eva Attling is a designer of jewelry. They moved to the United States a long time ago. And then they said, we're coming back to Sweden. If Trump wins, we're leaving. And I didn't believe it. You know, they were just being important. Yeah. And they didn't leave, they didn't come back. And then I remembered there were a lot of celebrities who said they were going to leave the United States if Trump won. So, and they didn't. They are still living there. So, and there are, I made a list. These are the guys that I know of. You know, there were more of them, of course. But these guys, these people I know from TV or movies or whatever. Jon Stewart, the comedian. Chelsea Handler, comedian. Miley Cyrus, the singer. Cher, you know her. Al Sharpton, you know this guy. Yeah. Spike Lee, the director. And Barbara Streisand. Yeah. She promised to move to Australia or Canada. They're so important, aren't they? You know, I'm leaving, so you better watch out. You know, I'm an important person. I'm gonna leave. You will miss me. You know, so you better not vote for Trump. I think it's pathetic. Amy Schumer, he's quite funny, I think. Samuel L. Jackson, right. George Lopez, the comedian. A lot of comedians. Whoopi Goldberg. And she denied she ever considered moving, but she said it. And Bryan Cranston. Yeah. He took it back. You know, I won't leave. So, yeah, that's what I want to say about these guys. Pathetic. So, and I'm looking forward to the French election. This is tomorrow. Big day here in Europe. Yeah. A lot of people have attention on this, interested, a lot of talks. There were talks about it this morning on Swedish television, and they sort of focus on the left-wing candidates. They have their hopes up. You know, maybe, just maybe, Marine Le Pen doesn't win. They are hoping. Yeah, it's silly to watch this. I still watch it, you know, because it makes me laugh sometimes, make me angry sometimes to watch the Swedish television, the news, the debates. But it's also inspiring, sort of, you know. You can see where things are going, actually, with these guys that are controlling the population of Sweden, or trying to control the thoughts here in Sweden. They're not, it's not working for them. Not as it used to, anyway. So, important day tomorrow. I'm thinking if she doesn't win, let's say, there's still hope. You know, it's a process. It's like an avalanche, really, that we see here in Europe. Yeah, and if Marine Le Pen wins, it will be faster. Of course, it's going to be good. But if she doesn't win, it will still not stop the avalanche. That's the thing that I want to say. Yeah. You will see the change here, you know, in Europe. You can see it already. It's very clear, obvious. So, but I hope she wins, and I think she's going to win. It's all up to the French citizens. Do they have the guts enough to vote for her? That's the question that I'm asking. It's about guts. All right. See you later. Bye.